Welcome to Elegant Island Living and EILtv for this week's webisode, where we're on location at the King and Prince Golf Course. We're here today with Rick Maddox. He is the general manager of the golf course here. So Rick, tell us a little bit about the golf course here.
Well, we're excited about having you today. We were able to redo the golf course in 2009 and looking forward to showing you around and seeing some of the things we have to offer.
Yeah, it's very beautiful out here. So you did say that you redid a lot of stuff, so you're really excited about that. You said you're working on your second year after your renovation, so completely redid everything. So can you tell us a little bit about the renovation?
Well, we searched high and low to find an architect that would be willing to work with an original Joe Lee design and modify but not change the integrity. And we discovered grasses that we think will be generational, last a lot longer than what we previously had, but also playing conditions will be that much better and standards that much higher.
Now we moved inside here to the restaurant area. Now Rick, I see we have a menu here. The few times I've been here, I've had the chicken salad and it's been absolutely amazing. So you said that it's been the same recipe since, I guess, day one here, right?
That's correct. That's interesting that you say that, because we have been making the same recipe since the day we opened, and we actually have people come out just strictly for that.
Yeah, it is well worth the trip to the North End to have the chicken salad for lunch.
The pro shop opens every day at 7:30, and our first tea time is 8 o'clock. After 2 o'clock, we have a $62 after 2. So if you haven't been out to give the course a try, this next month would be a good time to do that.
We toured around the area, we went to the restaurant, we saw the wonderful view outside, and we've been in the pro shop. I think we should go out and have a little tea time and tour around the golf course. What do you think?
I agree. We have a surprise feature that we're looking forward to showing to everybody locally, because it's something unique and we're very proud of it.
Well, I'm excited, so we have to go see what it's all about.
Part of the renovation and research that we did said that for the next generation, you need a practice facility with course-like conditions. So we made it a point to establish a good celebration practice tee. We have a new putting green, a big 6,500 square foot putting green with mini verde. We have a big practice bunker like the bunkers on the course. Over here we have a 3,500 square foot chipping green. Out in the range, we have target greens at 60, 50, 70, 90. Over there, we have a practice sand bunker so you can hit fairway bunker shots. And we really set it up so that the golfer could come right up to the practice tee, hit a bucket of balls, hit a few sand shots, a few chip shots, a few putts, and be right on the first tee. Well, the interesting thing is, Kurt, this was a man-made lake that was just a ditch that came out of those woods. And all of this was dug, and now this is a 50-acre lake, which comes into play on number 9 and also on number 10 and number 18. In order to send the golfer a message and let him know that you should aim more to the left here, that we needed to add those bunkers to raise the standard of play on the course, because they were not there before. So that was just one of the things that he suggested. On the left side, we had a sleepy little bunker that just kind of bled off to the marsh. And he added the stack bunker on the bottom below the bunker on the left to make sure to protect that left side and to hopefully keep people from going in the marsh. Added the top lines in the back to give the mounding in the right side bunker to make sure that if you pushed it out a little bit, at least it would catch your ball before it went into the marsh.
So we finally made it over to the island holes. This is what Rick was explaining about the bridge work that connects each hole that's on a different island. So Rick, explain a little bit about the island holes to us.
Well, of course, the number 12 is the first hole, and a unique feature that we had here was that you came off the bridge and on the concrete, and you walked up to the tee. So what we did was bridge back from bridge to bridge, bring it up to the level of the tee, and we were able to double the size of the tee and stay within the DNR guidelines.
So Rick and I just finished up our tour of touring you around the King and Prince golf course. So we got to see all the hallmark holes and everything that makes this golf course so special. So Rick, I think that we should go back to the main clubhouse. What do you think?
Well, I agree. We can head past the 18th green and view the lake as we go by, as we talked about over on number 10, and then go to the 19th hole and have a refreshing cold drink.
Well, that sounds like a great idea after this hot day. So let's go.